honored and happy to be here with you. And I'm happy that we have all time and that we have a place to talk a little bit longer about basketball. The idea about this clinic came with talking with many of you, exchanging experience and talking about Switzerland basketball in general. And the idea is to make better players in Geneva and in the region. Basically, it's simple. Why passing? I think the passing and methodics in teaching passing is the most neglected of all technical elements in basketball. When we talk about techniques with the ball, dribbling, shooting, and passing, I think everywhere in Europe, coaches neglect passes more than they should.
Alors, bonsoir tout le monde. Pour faire un résumé donc à chaque fois de ce que dira le coach ce soir, déjà j'ai une question, est-ce que des gens ne parlent pas du tout anglais ici? Pas du tout, du tout. Ok, très bien. C'est vrai ou c'est une... Très bien. Alors, pour faire court, donc, bonsoir à tous. Je suis honoré d'être ici ce soir. Je pense que c'est une excellente chose d'organiser un clinique comme ça afin d'avoir le maximum de monde possible pour pouvoir transmettre un maximum de savoir aussi. L'idée de ce clinique, en résumé, c'est partie un peu de la discussion qu'il y a eu entre les coachs. Le but, au final, c'est de rendre les joueurs qu'on a à disposition ici à Genève meilleurs. Et puis, pourquoi est-ce qu'on a choisi le thème de la passe? Simplement parce que ce sujet est, à son égard, de son point de vue, un des sujets les plus négligés du basket, à combien même c'est un sujet très très important. Donc, c'est fondamental de commencer par ça. Pour le premier clinic de cette saison.
This is clinic for coaches of youth categories. I worked as a coach of youth categories for many years, and I worked as a coach of senior men's programs in Europe. And I can honestly say that consistency in working on passing makes your team better, and this is 100%. Whether we're talking about under 14, under 16, or under 18 kids, if we are consistent in what we are trying to do with them and what we are trying to teach them, we're going to have a successful group and a different group from the beginning of the season until the end of the season.
Alors, ce clinique est destiné à des catégories jeunesse, mais il est important de savoir que en tant que coach, Coach Audez a coaché des équipes jeunes, des équipes seniors également. Et le meilleur moyen de pouvoir rendre cet aspect qu'est la passe plus efficace dès le départ, c'est de travailler avec les jeunes au fondement, c'est-à-dire vraiment au tout début. Persévérer, la persévérance, c'est un aspect très important des sujets qu'on aborde. Quand on est persévérant à vouloir travailler un certain aspect des fondamentaux, tels que la passe par exemple, c'est le meilleur moyen de permettre à ces joueurs d'avoir du succès plus tard sur les petites choses.
You have the tougher job that I have right now. You have tougher jobs than I have right now because the toughest job in basketball is to teach kids fundamentals.
Il ne faut pas oublier que vous avez un rôle plus important que ce qu'il a pour l'instant, étant donné que vous occupez d'entraîner des jeunes, alors que Coach Rodez s'occupe d'une équipe senior.
I coach professionals and I still have to be on their heads every day about making the good passes and making good selection of passes. And for you, I think it's even worse.
Imaginez que en tant que coach d'une équipe professionnelle, il doit sans arrêt répéter ses fondamentaux, leur rappeler certaines bases. Alors il peut s'imaginer facilement le travail qu'il y a devant vous à enseigner à ces jeunes fondamentaux.
So the concept of the clinic is that we are going to start with basic passes and teach how to teach methodically pass by pass, the right proper handwork, core work, and the foot.
Alors, ce qu'on va commencer à faire, le concept du clinique d'aujourd'hui, c'est donc la passe.
So we are going to start from zero.
On va commencer de zéro avec la position du corps, la position des mains et des jambes, la droitesse du corps, et en commençant avec l'exercice de manière statique et en se dirigeant gentiment vers des exercices plus dynamiques.
And we're going to rebuild the knowledge until the group and collective tactics.
Et puis on montera gentiment jusqu'à aborder les thèmes de tactique de groupe sous l'angle de la passe toujours.
And I hope that you will see that the most complicated offensive sets.
Et donc j'espère par là que vous vous rendrez compte que les systèmes de jeu les plus compliqués
The reason why orphans is not successful.
Les raisons pour lesquelles souvent ces systèmes ne marchent pas.
It's not because we choose the wrong orphans.
It's because c'est pas parce qu'on a choisi le mauvais système ou la mauvaise attaque.
It's in 99% of times it's one of those basic elements that was not taught properly in the beginning.
Souvent, les erreurs proviennent souvent d'un petit détail qui n'a pas été correctement enseigné lors de l'apprentissage des fondamentaux.
So we're going to start with basic passes. We're going to start statically, then we're going to show dynamically, and then we're going to show importance of incorporating passing drills into a week programs and in condition.
Donc on commencera avec des passes, comme on l'a dit plus tôt, de manière statique. On bougera gentiment vers l'aspect dynamique. Et puis on regardera comment est-ce qu'on peut incorporer ça à des programmes
week. Because I know that you have problems, that you don't have 6 practices a week. I know that it's hard for you. So I'm going to give you one window how to incorporate basic passes into conditioning or other forms of practice.
Alors le coach est au courant que certains d'entre vous n'ont qu'à 1 ou 2 entraînements à disposition par semaine. Donc on verra aussi comment incorporer les exercices de passe, l'apprentissage, l'enseignement de la passe dans des programmes plus réduits tels que 1 ou 2 par semaine.
And then we're going to talk about, after the break, about selection of passes in group and collective tactics. Pick and roll, collaboration between shooter and a guard, and a collaboration between an inside player and outside player, which I think is the most delicate issue here, because talking to many of you, like for example with Patrice, we agree that we don't have big guys here. We don't have the big guys, as we said. So having the players who are technically very, very developed is going to make our team offenses and players more polyvalent and more dangerous. It doesn't matter if you don't have the big guys, but if you have guys who are taught properly to handle the ball on the low post and attack not only with shot, but also with pass and dribble, we're going to have a successful players.
Après la pause, on attaquera tout ce qui est la sélection des passes, donc le choix des passes dans la tactique de groupe. On verra également comment travailler avec la passe de meneur à ailier, d'ailier à l'intérieur, les joueurs du périmètre pour également les joueurs à l'intérieur. Ne pas oublier non plus que, comme le coach en discutait avec Patrice, il n'y a pas énormément de joueurs de grande taille à disposition en Suisse. C'est quelque chose dont on sait qu'on manque énormément. Donc si on travaille correctement ces fondamentaux-là dans la passe, on pourra rendre les joueurs qu'on a à disposition plus polyvalents et permettre à l'attaque de rouler sans cet aspect de manquement de personnes de grande taille.
So basically, we're going to start immediately, and I would love if you, I like my, when I teach a clinic, I would like that everybody participates actively in one drill or the other. So please, questions every time, stop the drill, anytime you want, ask a question or correct by yourself. Let's make this one interactive clinic. It's not only one directional, that we have a both-way communication.
Faisons en sorte que l'entraînement soit interactif. Le coach vous encourage à lever la main si vous avez des questions, à participer un maximum afin de rendre justement l'entraînement plus vivant.
Let's start. Three couples.
C'est nous parlons. Trois couples.
One couple, one player here, yellow line, another player yellow line. Yellow line. We're going to start basic teaching kids. Let's say that they are not under 19, they are not under 16. They are kids of under 10.
Partons du principe que ce sont des jeunes joueurs de moins de 10 ans.
And they just came to your practice because they love basketball.
Voilà, ils viennent d'arriver à l'entraînement parce qu'ils ont son
We're going to teach them first basic two-hand passes and how to perform them in a correct way.
Première chose, la passe à deux mains, comment la faire de manière correcte.
So the first drill is teach them to push pass with two hands. Now let's exchange 20 passes by yourself and we are going to all correct the passes. Push pass with two hands. Pass everybody. Everybody pass. Please pay attention to their footwork. Please pay attention how they hold the ball. Please pay attention how they hold the core. And then we are going to correct this together. Let's take example number one and let's watch his three passes. Okay, so what's the problem with him? Basically, his shoulder is broken, so he's totally breaking his biomechanical movement. So how can we expect this player to play a good 3-on-3 and make a good decision in 3-on-3 when he cannot perform 1-on-0? So let's correct this and tell him, son, we said two-hand pass. So not one hand pass, this is one hand pass. So we said two hands. When we talk about two hands, that means that thumb should be only a little bit separated on the ball, and he spreads the both hands equally and have a good grip on the ball. That's the first thing how you hold
the ball. Bonne prise du ballon avec les pouces un minimum séparés.
Not like this. So we hold a hand with two hands. And then we bring the ball to the chest and cover it up that we finish the pass with the top of the fingertips and the hands spread in the direction where the ball is going.
On va oublier que la fin du mouvement doit vraiment être avec les pouces et le bout des doigts qui regardent vers l'extérieur complètement.
So first, how is he holding the ball? That he has to hold the ball with both hands equal.
Bien d'attirer l'attention du joueur qui doit tenir la main, le ballon avec les deux mains disposées de la
because
même manière.
Because players have tendency, if they have right hand, they have ability to do this. This is not strong enough.
Droitier de la mettre du côté droit. Alors, il faut vraiment disposer les doigts de manière égale sur le ballon.
Keep pass. Pass. Hop. Pass. What's his problem? Legs extended, he doesn't use all his body strength to pass because he passed like this. So, proper football, when we teach players to pass, we tell that everything starts from feet as well.
They have also with les jambes.
Proper balance, legs slightly separated their shoulders.
Donc, séparer un peu les jambes dans l'axe des épaules.
Bravo. And flex.
Et bien sûr, baisser les jambes et faire en sorte que les jambes soient.
And when he passes the ball on the chest, we want him to step out and have an active feet every time.
À tout moment, les pieds doivent être un minimum surélevé du sol pour être.
So everybody, position, hold the ball like this, and step out with one leg, and ready to pass. Catch the ball, pass. Catch the ball, same thing, hands ready to catch. If you tell them to pass, and then just sit on the side, they will pass however they want. And this is leading into the later problems. So be behind them and correct them immediately. So let's go one time, extend the left hand and active feet one time, extend the right leg. Understand? So one time step out left, one time step out right. Every time, pull the ball to your chest and finish the pass now with two hands. Hands extended, not like this. Right, let's do it. Everybody do this. Flex your legs, step out one time left, one time right. Strong. Top of the fingertips. Top of the fingertips. Ball must have return rotation. Try to make a target, a chest of your body. Not lower body, upper body. You see, he's now so occupied with this that he only do with one leg. He forgot that he has to work on his footwork at the same time and to teach his legs how to stop in the moment of pass. And believe me, this detail is going to cost you 5 turnovers in transition maybe. Because players, when they have to pass the ball over there, full court in transition, they do not know how to stop. So you will have passes like this and offensive passes. So teach them footwork in the beginning, the proper stopping and footwork in the moment of pass, then flex. You have to be low. My players are also supposed to be like this. And they are professionals. Every player is too lazy to go down, believe me. Every player. My best player is always going to start the drill like this. And then I come to him and say, listen, my friend, you're paid, professional, get 20 centimeters lower, and then he comes down. And then he's not lazy anymore. So, make them be low. All the time. Low. Bravo. Opa. Low. Let's go. Footprint. That one. Lagos. Opa. Step out with the left hand. Pass left. Round. High. Right. Two hands. Stop. Okay. Now, if anybody's volunteered to make a correction of this player, to come on the court. Come and correct his hands. Go. Go behind him. Correct his hands from here. Come and close the ball. Aye. I can first watch it, and then correct. I guess. So, Rob, is he ready? I'm working. Rob, I know.
Okay, so it's true. So too much using his powers. He doesn't have a grip on the ball, right? To tell you. Pass.
You see, for example, another problem, extra movement on a risky zone. Yeah? So on the chest, not down low. Here, to the chest and up. No need to ball all the way down. Must have the strength to pull the ball, to catch the ball, bring it just to the stomach, pick it up. Rotation. Wow, correct. Both hands. Believe me, because of this, I have my team professionals 2 turnovers per game. Because of this. Okay. Second pass with 2 hands with each is a pass above the head. Exchange 20 passes above the head. Opa. Strong. So, now we come to the same problem. So, the most important thing, believe me, is that you start correcting his feet. Because again, you see his legs are like this. He is not ready to make a full strength of the pass. Believe me, he's not ready to pass. Again, how is he holding the ball? He cannot make a pass above the head like this. We said, we teach them 2 hands equally. I don't care if you are left-handed or right-handed.
Peu importe que soit droitier ou gaucher, la manière dont vous disposez les doigts sur le ballon, c'est la base.
Equally with 2 hands. Push pass. Equally with 2 hands above the head pass. So, holding the ball. How is he holding the ball? And then step up with one step. As strong as possible. Not to bring the ball behind the head.
Et pas ramener le ballon derrière la tête.
C'est pas unwritten rule is the ball is on the level of the head with the ball above.
Une des règles non écrites du basket, c'est que la passe part au niveau de derrière la tête, mais pas derrière, vraiment à la même hauteur.
Bravo. Ok. Spine and the back. Are the neck and the back are in a straight position. Never like this.
Gardez la colonne droite vraiment droite. Le bas du dos et la nuque doivent vraiment rester droits.
Opa. This is we have to correct. And his eyes must look in front of him. So now let's go exchange the passes above the head with a step out, 2 hands as strong as possible. So finish the pass with the fingertips. Opa. Boom. We see now who players are 18 years old. We see which players are 16 years old. Of course, a lack of motoric skills, physical skills, sometimes can be a problem. He cannot pass the ball with the same strength. Okay, hop up. Change the foot. Left. Stop. Okay. And now we have a problem with him. That his pass is not strong enough to reach over there. So we have to help him to perform this element better.
Il faut faire attention aussi à certains joueurs qui n'auraient pas la force nécessaire tout de suite de faire des passes à plus longue distance. Tout de suite corriger ça et essayer de faciliter.
Come one step closer.
Juste de rapprocher un tout petit
peu. Just be successful and make the pass, the strongest pass with technically correct. Boom. Strong. Finish. Bravo. Extension. You have to extend your hands in the direction of the ball. Okay? So here we have a situation that we have a physically inferior player trying to perform one technical effort.
Donc là, on a une situation d'un joueur qui est physiquement un peu moins costaud que d'autres et qui, pour qui, mais qui doit quand même réussir à faire l'exercice correctement au final.
And we cannot put him in a system to put him in a situation that he do this pass successfully unless we help him to develop this element.
Donc pour rendre l'exercice efficace pour lui et pour faire en sorte qu'il réussisse l'exercice de la meilleure manière possible, il faut lui faciliter les conditions.
So we don't waste time. We explain 2 push pass, chest, above the head pass, and now we're going to talk about bounce pass. It's the same thing. Step out,
And ball has to bounce in the above third of your body.
Donc on parle maintenant de la troisième passe.
So this is body is one third, one, two, three. In this third, the ball has
voilà où que la balle doit arriver plus ou moins en troisième.
Exchange 20 passes. Boom, I'm sinking.
Même chose, rebond sur.
Strong, strong, strong. Step up.
You have to make them use their explosiveness of the hand. They will try to do this. They will try to do this because they cannot do this. They will try to do this, but stop. So this pass on the floor around the head, that is
very hard. Very hard.
So make it easier for them that they are successful perform the technical task that you give.
Utilisez les deux mains de la même manière, ça reste la clé de l'exercice.
Let's go, one hand pass.
On passe à une main.
Push pass of the left hand from the hip, one hand push pass. Let's exchange 20 passes with the left hand.
Faites la main gauche, une seule passe, on part. On part de la main gauche, une seule.
Let's go, on part. Hey, well, we already see a problem. When you talk about teaching him push pass with one hand. What is his problem? He's using almost a baseball pass. It's not a baseball pass. This is baseball pass. This is a push pass. This is a push pass and he's bringing the ball up. The ball has to be on his left hip. So the ball is here. Forearm and on vertically on the surface of the ball, 90 degrees. Wrist, ready to dribble and pass, not like this. And the elbow back.
So,
but at the same time, back straight, knees flat.
Donc plein de choses en même temps. Hein. Position de ta main sur le ballon, vraiment avoir l'avant-bras droit. Le poignet tourné comme s'il allait partir en dribble et l'épaule haute. Donc pas oublier de garder le dos droit et les jambes fléchies pour pouvoir faire une passe dont qui ne part pas derrière l'épaule. Vraiment vers l'avant.
And there we go. Push pass front. Same with the step. On part front. Left again. Step up. On part. Change the leg. Change the leg again. No problem. On part. Okay. So let's do it like this. Correct. Immediately how we hold the ball. The palm, the wrist has to be ready to pass. This is not ready to pass. This is not ready to pass. This is wrist ready to pass. Ah, let's go. Let's pass. Pa, pa, pa. Ah, okay. On the hip, stop. Continue. On the hip. On the hip. Up. Push. Push. Make it push stronger and stronger. Right hand push pass. The same time, you have to tell him, hey, Meister, please, don't break your back. Be straight. Try to be straight so you use explosives on your arm. Because if you teach under 12 or under 10, you have to teach them the basics, but you have to bring them closer. So they are successful in this part.
For the moins de 12, the moins de 10 ans, it's very important to les faire commencer tout près l'un de l'autre. Il y a cette force de faire ses passes.
Don't expect too much.
Ne pas attendre trop.
My biggest problem when I started to learn for cadets under 14 was that I was not following the rule of progressives.
Donc le plus gros, par exemple, sur un plan plus personnel, sur la plus grosse erreur, c'était en coachant des moins de 14, de ne pas respecter la règle de progrès.
I wanted to do everything in one week.
faire tout en une semaine.
It was my mistake. We have to go step by step.
Étape par étape, ne pas oublier que.
We want to teach them how to pass to dribble to the shooter, for example.
Juste avant de faire une passe, juste après un dribble, c'est un peu compliqué.
For the shooter, and he doesn't know how to pass to dribble. Forget about it. Don't expect too much. Teach them
basic.
Yeah, he has a problem. Again, he has a problem. He's doing this. Falling on the nose every time. Back straight. Hands down. Push pass. Pass back. Push pass. Change one time left, one time right. Exchange 20 perfect passes. One time right, one time left. Did you see what I was talking about? Elbow, wrist, everything. Let's go. Up. Let's go. Right. Elbow up. On the hip. Don't hide. Stop. Put the ball on the hip. Elbow up. Hands down. Back straight. And now from the hip. Boom. Right. Boom. One hand. Okay. Bravo. Thank you. Okay, guys, one hand push pass. And then we have to talk about one hand push pass. And now we incorporate the most important thing when we talk about passing is the footwork and techniques of stopping and starting. The most important thing when we talk about passing.
L'élément le plus important quand on parle de la passe, c'est le travail des jambes, le travail des pieds plutôt, et la différence entre l'arrêt et le mouvement.
Bravo. Technique of stopping and starting. Okay. So we go. Technique of starting. When we talk about one hand bounce pass with a cross step, we also have to be ready to start. So let's start the drill with triple threat position.
Okay.
And let's go with a cross step, passing the ball. Now this element, 1 turnover per game in my team. Because we have problem to put the ball on the post. My players have tendency to do this. Waiting for a big guy, like we have Shaquille O'Neal. So, on the hip, bounce pass. Let's go. One time right, one time left. Hoppa, bravo. Let's go. On the hip. Step up. Cross step. Okay. Again, we see problems that they're bringing the ball too high. They cannot bring the ball too high. They stop and they cannot bring the ball. The ball must be on the hip because we have to protect them. Do you understand? We have to protect the ball.
Protéger le ballon.
And the proper way to protect the ball is on the hip. And now we go to progress. We progress with the drills, with the education. And we give them a pass after dribble. So now we're talking about controlling the dribble, incorporating dribble and pass, and the proper footwork of stopping.
Là, pour nous permettre aussi de s'améliorer au fur et à mesure de l'exercice, on va incorporer le dribble, la passe après le dribble.
And now we're going to pass the ball on the floor after we stop with one touch. Go. Okay, go back. And then you go. Catch, dribble. And then change the rhythm. Stop with one touch. It's cross step past the ball. Alright, let's go. Very simple. Alright, let's go. Allez. Bravo. Boom. Let's go. Stop. One touch. Bravo. Alright, go. Dribble. Position. We cannot tell them to cross step like this. Because how is he going to come back? So shot fake, stop with one touch, so you can go in both directions. And that's why you stop with one touch.
C'est la raison pour laquelle on s'arrête sur un temps. Ça va partir à droite.
Roll on the hip, rotation on the top of the thing, top of the toes, or on the front part of the foot, or not.
Donc la rotation se fait avec la partie extérieure des pieds.
And ball on the hip and pass. One time to the left, one time to the right. Now what's going on? Up, up. Strong, forward. Okay. Let's go now more dynamic. Bas, as soon as you catch, you make a jump step. After the jump step, we go to cross step, and make a pass with one. Pass. And you are ready to catch. I do this. Catch, pass. Catch, another side. Alright, let's go. So you teach him that this can start. Now what is important to make the pass successful when you talk about dribble? That direct dribble before the pass, when you talk about push pass with one hand, is the strongest dribble that is preparing your palm for amortization of the ball to make a good move.
Le plus important, c'est vraiment préparer sa main pour que quand le ballon va remonter, qu'on puisse l'amortir de manière correcte et avoir les doigts suffisamment pour pouvoir renvoyer le ballon.
Because they will have a tendency to do this, which is not good.
La tendance à faire ça, c'est va être naturel, mais c'est pas bien.
But if you tell them, they start to dribble, the back is straight, the broken footwork, and they have made a strong dribble before the pass, then the pass is strong.
Les obliger à penser que pour que la passe soit faite de la manière la plus correcte, il faut vraiment que le dernier dribble avant la passe soit suffisamment fort pour que la paume soit ouverte pour faire la passe correcte le plus fort.
Okay, so let's go now. One time. Dribble with left. Three times. And we make a step out and pass with one hand. Push pass left here. Catch. Go. Hop. Active feet. Boom. Bravo. Right, let's go. The strongest dribble is the dribble before the pass. So let's make it work. So, what's his problem? He's too low, but also what? Breaking his back. What is also problem? He has a tendency to dribble and twist his palm. Do you see? So this is bad habit. This is a bad habit. This will destroy your game. This. When they player have a habit to do this, that means that he is not properly taught how to dribble. This is not a clinic about dribble. This is about passing. But dribbling is important as a good preparation for a pass.
Bien que ce ne soit pas un clinique sur le dribble, il faut aussi savoir que le fait de dribbler correctement, c'est
thérapeutique. First of all, he's dribbling here. He doesn't dribble properly. So you have to correct this. Teach him how to dribble the ball properly. Elbow up, wrist on the top of the surface of the ball, finish the dribble with a finger. Okay, and you have to feel comfortable. So feel comfortable. This is not comfortable. You have to be back straight and ready to do everything. And then you can tell him, let's go maestro, push past one hand. But if you didn't prepare him for a good dribble, no chance he will do it. You will turn over the ball.
Très important, avant de commencer à expliquer ce que c'est une passe à une main, etc., de bien maîtriser le dribble avec son temps avant de
passer. Try, let's go. Strongest dribble. Hop. Bravo. Allez. Quebec. Now, strongest people before a pass. Now, now, now. Hey, is an important element when we talk about passes. And the last pass with one hand is a baseball pass that I think that the kids under 12 and under 14 has to teach is a baseball pass with one hand. A baseball pass, a step out with the opposite leg. You're bringing the ball up with two hands. And you split it when the ball is in the level of the shoulder.
Et dès que la main, dès que le bras arrive à hauteur de l'épaule, séparer les bras l'un de l'autre.
And then make
it. Faire une baseball pass.
And also the pass is finished with the top of the finger.
Pas oublier les doigts qui finissent la passe avec le bout des doigts.
And the hand is pointed in the direction of the pass.
Les doigts aussi regardent vers l'endroit où on fait la passe.
Pass. Okay. Let's go now. 20 passes baseball pass. 20 passes. Okay. Hop.
Finis bien.
Hop. Make your work on the precision. This is precision. Alright. Now, bring the ball up. So we don't see many precision. Strong one. Strong pass. Alright, strong. Boom. Strong. Strong. Too much.
Too much.
Too much. Too much. Stay balanced. Stay balanced. Okay. And because of the nature of the game.
Say it again, please.
Because of the nature of the game.
Okay. À cause de la nature du jeu.
Because the game is not the same like it was 20 years ago.
Étant donné que le jeu évolue, ce n'est plus le même jeu qu'il y a 20 ans en arrière.
It's, we can say that there are two different sports because of the intensity.
L'intensité a fait que c'est devenu deux sports différents carrément.
We need to teach player proper technique.
La technique correcte. Doit être enseigné aux joueurs.
So they are not surprised with aggressive defense.
Alors pour qu'ils ne soient pas surpris par des défenses plus agressives aujourd'hui.
And also the pass that I teach the lately is a pocket pass. Pocket pass is also the pass but in the opposite direction of your move.
Ce qu'il appelle la pocket pass, la passe qui serait à l'opposé de là où le corps se dirige. Donc,
it's very important for the collaboration. For the collaboration, big and shoot. So, it's very important for the collaboration, big and shoot. And also develops the players feeling for the ball and the drift.
Très important cette passe là pour la collaboration entre les shooters et les grands par exemple.
Okay. So let's go. The other way, two dribbles and a pocket pass to a pass. So we go one, two, stop. Don't go one, two. No way, because it's offensive foul. So be ready to stop. Alright, let's go. Diagonal. Here. Opa. Alright, let's go. Diagonal. Also, you have to tell that the most important thing is that you make the strongest dribble is direct dribble before the pass. The one that prepares your palm to make a good and successful pass.
Très important d'insister sur le fait que le dribble juste avant la passe, c'est le dribble qui doit être le plus fort de tout ce fait avant pour que le ballon puisse, que la paume se soit suffisamment prête à renvoyer la balle avec la force suffisante.
Alright, let's go. All right. Let me hear this strong strip. No, thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
Bars on the base. On the base. We did everything statically. We did everything statically. And we're going to show now the importance of pivoting and dribble dynamics. What I want to say, you had some papers that we prepared for you, and within those papers are some rules and methodics in teaching kids the technique and phases of learning. So the first phase of learning is receiving information. Like in any school, you have to receive your information first.
La première phase d'apprentissage, c'est de recevoir, d'être à même de recevoir l'information. C'est la première chose primordiale.
And the player or the kid has to have a visual idea what is the movement about.
Le joueur ou l'enfant à qui on enseigne doit visualiser quel est le mouvement à faire.
Second phase.
Deuxième phase d'apprentissage.
The second phase is building the knowledge. So we are progressing in rebuilding his knowledge with adding another element, like footwork, like dribble before the pass, or pivot before the pass.
Construire le savoir toujours en ajoutant des choses de manière toujours évidemment progressive.
Third phase of learning is stabilization of certain technical element. So the player has to stabilize the certain element in various drills, 2-on-1, 3-on-2, 4-on-4, whatever, there are millions of drills to stabilize a certain element.
La troisième phase, c'est la stabilisation de ce savoir, c'est donc de revoir ce qu'on vient de faire durant la phase 1 et 2, mais dans plusieurs circonstances.
And the final phase of learning is automatization. So the player is ready to perform a certain element without thinking about what he has to do. And this is a game situation.
Et la dernière phase, c'est de rendre évidemment cet élément qu'on vient d'apprendre automatique, pour qu'il n'ait plus à réfléchir en phase de jeu.
Bon. Screen. Big guy, shoot another basket. Screen for Nick. Stop. Be there. Screen for shoot. And you have a pointer. Hi, screen. Is this good pass?
No.
So, the last phase of automatization, you want to play that 3-on-3. And you want the point guard to give a good pass. But how can he give a good pass if we didn't teach him? Either, for example, curl. If we didn't teach him, that if he curls, that you have to make the one pass dribble backwards, you open the angle to make a good pivot pass. We didn't teach him in the first phase, and we expect the point guard to pass this pass. Very hard.
Très important de commencer dans la première phase à expliquer les situations de jeu dans lesquelles telle ou telle passe peuvent arriver. Donc on ne demande pas des choses alors que la personne ne peut pas les réaliser.
Let's go. In pairs, we start with open step. So shot fake. Open step, ball in the hip, and we dribble to the zero. You follow me. Hop. 1, 2, 3. We start with 2 touches.
Okay.
We start with 2 touches.
Center.
Right. Every pass after front pivot to our back. Catch, send in, shot fake, open step. No travel. Stop.
Correct. Hoppa. First dribble, then step. Same time. Hoppa, boom.
Now. Same thing. Change with it. Stop. 2 touches.
Stop. 2 touches. Stop. Back. Opposite. Left, right.
Now. And make a front pivot to pass. Push pass with 1 minute. Like I did. Right. I go. Same thing. Make a pivot to pass. Let's do it. Dynamically, we are giving them more. And we are entering the progressive phase. But make sure that you stop correctly. And now we're going to see if they are able to stop. Let's see if they are able to stop. Stop with 2 touches. 2 contacts. How do you say?
Stop with 2 contacts.
How do you talk?
Yes, sir.
Hoppa.
Hoppa.
Hoppa. Hey, hey, go. Okay, we're gonna try to make them better in this room. So let's go, guys. Noe, George, last. Dribble to the sideline, and another player dribble to the side. And we have to teach the players how to stop. With 2 touches. And be ready to make the pivot. And protect the ball. Because this is also avoiding of the trap situation. And this player is very, this is 2-0, the simplest drill in the world, but it's most complicated. If you want them to perform technical levels, it's already. Let's go, Ale. Pivot, pass. Go, go, go. Teach the player the proper stopping technique. When he dribbles with the left hand, he is right and left. The same thing, he has to be ready in the moment when he stops to shoot, pass, or dribble. Triple threat position.
Toujours s'arrêter en position de triple menace, ça reste plus important quand il s'arrête, quand le joueur observe un temps d'arrêt.
Because one of my players, I don't want to say names, is not able to stop in the left side, we have one turnover for him.
Parce qu'un des joueurs de son équipe, donc il ne citera pas le nom, n'arrive pas à faire cet arrêt de temps, on tient le bout un ballon perdu par
match. He makes this. So he's not able to stop. Give me a ball. So I teach him how to stop every day, because he has 22 years, I have to teach him how to stop every day. So when he drives, he has to make a dribble strongest, the first long step, and the second shot. And then he will be ready to see everything and pass everywhere. So we have to teach them how to stop in order to make them better pass. I hop up. Boom. Okay, I hop up. Direct, direct. Left, right. Round. Hop up. Right, left. Round. Good. I Ale. Ale, change. Change your shift. Sprint. Charge, charge. Aye, sprint. Charge. Ale. If you start a practice every day, it's giving them different assignments. You will have 1 month different players. And you will have better offense. For sure. Round. Okay. The next one. Pass. Same thing. Come to the base. Two passing dribbles. And you pass after reverse spin. So what is the reverse spin? Also before the spin. The strongest dribble with the step out. And look how I escape the trap or aggressive defense. And I protect the ball. Basically, I do everything. I did everything to make my teammate receive the ball.
Pour échapper à une frappe potentielle ou à une défense agressive, mais
bien des dribbles à prendre. Try to do it. Not easy, I know, but try to do it. Allez, let's go. Oh. So, not good. Not good. Back straight, dribbling strong. And before spin, strong dribble. Hop up. It's not easy, I know. But in order to make a good pass, he has to be able to make a good dribble. And of course he has to understand. Stop. Dribble the ball. Stop. Dribble the ball. He has to feel comfortable in this position. But we cannot expect him to make this pass to escape the trap. If he's not comfortable with dribble, before players who are not comfortable with dribble has subconscious escape. What is subconscious escape? I stop. Because I don't feel comfortable in this position. And now he makes turnover because if you do this, it's a turnover. And you're screaming at him, you idiot. I do it as well. But let's teach him how to avoid traps. Let's teach him how to use different passes, and then you will not have problems. Alright, hop up. Back, spin, front, back, spin, reverse. you give them this type of drills,
si vous leur donnez ce genre d'exercice,
first 10-15 minutes of practice, and you give them every 2 or 3 days this type of drills with different tasks.
Donc en leur donnant à chaque fois, tous les 2-3 jours, ce genre d'exercice avec chaque fois des tâches différentes, mais toujours dans la même optique.
I think that in 3 months you will have more success in your role.
En commençant vos entraînements 10-15 minutes avec ce genre de petits détails, au bout de 2 à 3 mois, on voit déjà la différence.
Okay. Now let's go to one practical drills for you that we also do and I did with kids. When you have one core and you have, I want to tell you that no matter how many kids you have on practice, you can always work on something. It's not important if you have 10 players in practice. It's not important. With 3, 5, 6, 7, 11, 15, you can always make them incorporate passes into conditioning and make it useful. And one of those drills that we do,
try and make points. Points.
Here,
and here.
You sit, stay. Bravo. Okay. And let's say that you have 10 players. And you have 5 players working on this court, and you can have 5 players working the same thing on the other side, but with different tasks. So you say, this group is working on 3 different passes, dynamically. First pass. As soon as I reach the vertical line, he is posting up very aggressively. Opa, drop it.
Bravo.
And I stop with one touch, and I make a pass. Okay?
I make a pass.
Boom. Or direct pass. Okay, that's the first pass. I go to this position. You catch. Second pass is a pass from inside the ball. So what we want from this player? After posting up, he did everything what he has to do. He makes it back to you and you face the bus. Okay. Flash. And we make this player pass upon the head from the shoe. Okay? Alright, over. Here is the left. Bravo. Good. And now we make this pass, this player finished the layup, make him jump, and he opens one strong pass in transition to another player. Two hand push pass in transition. And they always rotate, okay? Alright, you go here,
you go there,
you go there, you go there. Okay? Hey. Stop. Beginning of the drill. Right. Hey, let's give them one encouragement, guys. Right? Jump, back to you, like in defensive rebound.
passe. Square dribble. Okay. In the same time, we can make this player work on the handle. Just one more apology. Handoff is very important technique also, but we will not work with the handoffs too much. So this player, when he gets the ball, he will hand off the ball to this player. Correct. And you catch the ball, you will. Okay? Let's do it. Oh! Oh, that's good. Thank you. Pass. Now speed, handoff. Go, speed, come on, right. Cut. Bravo! You see, and now, you know, you have to really build them, and then drill get the dynamical purpose. But he has to understand, when we say back pivot, he has to do back pivot. We cannot be tolerant. We cannot be tolerant, because they have to learn how to think.
On ne peut pas être sur les ronces, des petits détails qui peuvent avoir toute leur importance plus tard. On
parle de l'intelligence. Let's say back field.
Ouvrir vers le terrain.
Back field. Not like this. This is not pass. Not against aggressive defense. So catch, back field, pass on the hand. Sprint, hand up, sprint, pass on the cut. Alright, let's go.
Allez.
Inside game, hoppa. Now, go there. Go there. Pass, go. Hoppa. Go. Anybody has any questions, please ask me, because it's going too fast. Okay, so we give them different tasks, but we cannot give them this before we teach them how to do it. Because if you give them a drill, it's not important what you practice. There are millions of drills on internet. The important is that you decide, take three drills, but they do it how you want them to do it. Or don't do it. It's important what you do and how do you do it. It's more important.
Le plus important, c'est qu'il y a des millions d'exercices sur Internet, chacun c'est très facile d'en trouver. Mais choisissez ceux qui vous paraissent les plus adaptés à votre équipe et faites en sorte qu'ils les fassent, qu'ils les réalisent exactement comme vous souhaitez qu'ils les réalisent.
So if you do this, he stops and he makes this pass. You have to tell him stop, no good.
On fait tout de suite des erreurs, voyez.
Let's go. Pass. Okay. He has to make a pivot, stay in balance. Pass. Right. So we make a precision of the drill. This is important. Okay. Okay. Let's go one more round. Big pivot. Bravo. Good job. Pass. Strong pass, push pass. Okay. Sit down. So we just talked about basic passes.
On a parlé juste des passes basiques.
And now we're going to talk about how to incorporate last 10 minutes of this part of the lecture. 10 minutes, yeah? The last thing about this part of the lecture is incorporating the passes in your every week programs. I know it's hard to organize a practice when you have 1 hour and a half, three times per week.
On se rend compte qu'il est difficile d'organiser un entraînement complet quand on a qu'une heure et demie, deux, voire trois fois par semaine.
And you have to think about offensive practice, defensive practice, conditioning.
faut se rendre, qu'il faut se décider, est-ce qu'on fait un exercice?
More shoot or more dribble, what I have to do? So we incorporate different elements. So what we do a lot with Mike as well in the senior program, we incorporate stabilization and prevention, especially for young players who grow fast, like he does, whose skeleton went very fast and his muscles didn't grow enough to protect his skeleton. We do stabilization drills and incorporate passes. So we say to them, take the shoes off for now. We take the shoes off and we work on balance. One leg. Push past two hands 30 times. And hop up. Okay? And let's go, Alex. Keep the balance. One leg, back. Push past. Finish the pass. Extend the hands. Ball has to be rotated. Rotate the ball. Bravo, rotate the ball other way. Hoppa, stop, change the leg. Bravo, and now let's do another drill. We go with the ball down. We work on the protection of the knee ankle, bottom ankle, and the hips in the same time. We stabilize, pass. We make it touch the floor and pass above the head. Extremely strong. And jump, boom. Bravo, go down, bravo, flex the leg, go down, bravo. Okay, so turn the bench. We all have this in our gyms. We all have this in our gyms, and also three players on the bench, three players on the pressure or on the bump, or show easy. Same thing. Bench. Hoppa, take this one. Okay, let's go. Stay on bench, pass. And make them do different things.
Utiliser le banc pour leur faire réaliser différents exercices.
Make them pass to the dribble.
Même en utilisant un dribble.
Okay. Or pass to the floor.
Pass au sol.
Or pass to one leg.
Pass sur une jambe.
So this is all working in the same time and developing the feeling for the ball, correct passes and the bounce.
Essayer d'incorporer les passes, le dribble à la condition physique en utilisant les objets à disposition.
And the most important coordination, because if we take physical skills, strength, speed, endurance, power, agility and flexibility, the most sensitive is coordination, working on coordination in your programs.
Travailler un maximum la coordination, peu importe les qualités qu'ils ont au niveau.
That's why they say that coordination is motorical intelligence.
C'est pour ça qu'on dit que la coordination c'est l'intelligence.
L'intelligence de physiquement. Oui, bravo. That's why the best basketball players are the most coordinated ones. Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, Scottie Pippen. They all have perfect coordination and motorical intelligence. So, when we talk about pivoting, teaching the kids how to pivot, and in the balance at the same time, Noah knows we work for 1 hour, drill like this, for example, when he has to be on the same line. All right, good, do the drill. Bravo, here, you have red line. Hoppa. Fast pivot, bravo, good, bravo. And he cannot miss the red line. He has to be always on the red line when he makes a pivot. Back pivot, and front pivot now. Front pivot. Another way.
Yeah,
bravo, I hope. Front. Bravo, front out. No. Bravo, frontal pivot. Front, bravo. Now, front. Okay, so make you have to teach him how to pivot. You have to teach guys what is a front pivot and what is a back pivot when the back goes first. Very important for the passes. So we always have to realize that pass is not only about pass, it's about how you dribble, how you pivot, how you protect the ball. How you dribble, how you pivot, how you protect the ball.
Comment dribbler, comment pivoter avec le ballon, c'est souvent ça le plus important.
Of course, retardants, I don't mean this negative, there are accelerants in every group and there are retardants.
Il y a toujours des gens qui toujours des retardataires, quel que soit l'exercice qu'on fait.
Every group, under 14, under 12, under 16.
Toujours ceux qui ont un peu de peine à suivre.
But every group has accelerants, the players who develop faster, biologically, genetically.
Il y a ceux qui s'améliorent.
For example, he and him, he's accelerant, he's stronger, he's physically more strong. So we have to take this one and make him work on his weaknesses more.
Donc simplement prendre ceux qui ont plus de facilité à s'améliorer dans certains aspects et les faire travailler sur là où ils ont le plus de faiblesses.
So if Alan's problem is his upper body because of the skeleton, because of the muscles, we isolate upper body, we give him medicine ball.
Donc voilà, on lui donne une balle. Si son problème est dans le.
And then he has to use all the upper body muscles and give me 100 presses above the head, strong, extra strong, boom, 100, strong, boom, only head, bam. And we give him this for 10 minutes after practice, that he do this to make on his upper body strength. Yeah. And the last drill, what I like to do with seniors, don't send them two players each court. Here we just eight players. So two players in each corner here. No, it's not. Go there. Hey maestro, two players in each corner. Go there. Okay, so we do this. In seniors, we do it for 5 minute sets. If they make a mistake, we have to go back. For example, we do this. I know it's not the same thing to punish big men and punish the kids because they have a lot of practice. But for example, when I want to put pressure on my players, I give them this drill. If they make a mistake, he goes home. You know, if I see that they cannot do this drill, I cannot do 5 on 5 with them.
L'exercice, il le donne souvent aux joueurs des Lions Genève, par exemple, et la punition, c'est que si au bout de 5 minutes, ils font une erreur, ils rentrent à la maison.
And I give them simple drill.
Selon la catégorie d'âge des joueurs.
And I give them simple drill, and I see if they think or they don't think. If they don't think, I send them all home. I cannot do 5 on 5, if they don't think.
Impossible pour lui de les faire travailler 5 contre 5 s'ils ne voient pas de réflexion de leur part.
Ok, so we go. One pass, take the ball. Ball over there, right. Give him the ball. Right. Ok. Left and dribble together, papa. We stop with one touch. We pass the ball to the right with above the head. And we sprint to the left side. You understand? We pass the ball to the right and go to the left. Go! Left and dribble. Pass to the right. Pass to the right and go to the left.
Pass to the right and go
to the left. Pass to the right. Go to the left. Go. Pass to the right and go to the left. Left and dribble. Left and dribble. One touch stop. So they're continuously working on their cardio training. Okay, guys. Let's do it good. Okay. Hey, tell me. Be loud. Let's do it good.
Go there. Équilibre un peu.
Left hand dribble.
Dribble avec la main gauche. Hein,
we stop in one touch.
Ça arrête sur un s'arrête instant.
We pass to the right.
Passer à droite. Go to the left. Et sprinter à gauche. Ok?
Dribble avec la main. If we make a mistake, we go on zero. I'm ready. Hoppa. Run. Pass. Ok, he's not doing a correct pass, but. Pass. Two hands. Go. You forget. So, for example, it's not perfect. It's not a perfect drill for under 40. But I want to tell you that, for example, we have to take passing very seriously. And passes are also about concentration.
Prendre le sujet de la passe, c'est un sujet à prendre très au sérieux. Et la concentration qui entoure les chaque exercice que vous faites, c'est très important aussi.
Or for example, I give them this. Dribble to the right hand, change direction, to the legs, and then make a push pass, and then go over there.
you give them different things.
But if
I see them make 5 mistakes in 1 minute, I see that their heads are not ready for practice. We cannot make 5 of 5 after this. Because what I'm going to talk in the air, and they cannot do simple trick. If I see that they are here ready, then we can go. I mean, this is just an example how serious we have to take passing. Because if they feel that you are weak in not correcting them, if they think that you sleep sometimes, when you tell them 10 times, please push pass with 2 hands strong, and then he do it 10 times strong, and then you're not looking and he does 6 times totally something different, we have to be more persistent than they are.
Simplement, il faut être beaucoup plus persévérant que ce que eux sont. Il ne faut pas qu'ils se rendent compte que vous faites 10 fois, il fait 10 fois l'exercice faux pour le corps.
Because they have to understand that this is a serious thing. It's a big responsibility to pass and make your team a better player, and also expect him to make you a better player when he is ready to share the ball with you in the right way.
Pas oublier que le but premier de la passe, c'est qu'au moment de faire la passe à quelqu'un, on est censé le mettre dans des conditions idéales pour pouvoir continuer l'action. Mettre un panier, faire la meilleure passe à son tour.
Because you know as well that one assist makes 2 people happy and one slam dunk only 1 player happy. Yeah? So this is conditioning and passing. And to finish just with 1 drill that we also do in a dynamic way, and we make responsibility to the catcher as well, is that we make 2 dribble spots. When I start to dribble, you start to sprint. One ball, hold the ball. When he starts to dribble, you start to sprint. When he starts to dribble, you start to sprint. Let me change position. Okay, ready? Pass. So, we try to make it, try to make that the first player passes with the dribble and everybody else runs and pass without dribble. Right. Try to do it. Dribble pass, catch the pass, sprint the pass. You understand? When he catches, you sprint. It's easy drill. This drill is very easy. If you start slowly, then you reveal it to the complicated level. But also they always run. They always have to show their hands where they want the ball. So the responsibility of the player who catch the ball, to show the target and be ready to catch and stuff at the same time and passing. But you cannot give them this drill, I repeat, if you didn't give them the basics.
Sans donner les bases avant, c'est difficile de les lancer sur un exercice comme ça avant qu'ils aient eu les détails auparavant.
So if the player is not able to stop with 2 touches,
si le joueur n'est pas capable de s'arrêter 2 temps
of the right and left dribble,
sur un dribble à droite ou un dribble à gauche,
if the right player is not ready to stop with 1 touch and make a pivot front or back,
si le joueur n'est pas capable non plus de s'arrêter 1 temps et de faire un spin, que ce soit à droite ou à gauche,
if the big guy is not ready to pivot, we cannot expect them to be a good passers as well.
C'est difficile d'attendre d'eux qu'ils passent des excellentes passes s'ils n'ont pas ces fondamentaux là.
Okay, I suggest we take a short break and we continue after. Thank you very much. So, we will talk about now selection of pass in group and collective tactics. But we are going to start isolating the elements. So, if for example we have a situation within our system, we can take whatever offense you want. You can choose offense later. But let's say defense, offense. Okay? Make a good pass.
Make a sprint. Like a back screen for you. Sprint.
Wrap. Pass. Hand off. Everybody there, ready. Okay, so 3 times he's lifting, 3 times offense. change up three times.
Complete the 3 times.
So for example, we will explain the drills, but also we will explain how practice goes. From 2-on-0, building the practice to 3-on-3. So develop their finesse. Screen, open for the ball, pass. Pass. Handoff. Fake handoff, bra.
Fake, I'm sure.
We teach them how to handoff the ball. So he has to be responsible after the screen. Show the hand where he wants the ball, face the basket, make a front pivot for the hand. Not defense was very aggressive. One more pivot in the pass. So we're teaching the big guys how to hand off the ball properly.
Donc on apprend au grand, au pivot, à comment faire un handoff properly avec les big pivots.
Because handoff is like a screen. You have to protect the ball like you're making a screen.
Parce que c'est comme un bloc qui doit protéger le ballon.
Ball is close to the body.
Donc le ballon est proche du corps.
Inside hand is on the top of the ball.
La main intérieure sur le ballon.
And outside hand is under.
Et la main extérieure sous le.
Not like this, not like this. So the player can take the ball in your hand. Take.
So
this is the way of teaching the proper technique of hand. But we will not waste time on this. It's just an example. So we teach big guys. See the screen open. See the basket. Back front pivot. One more pivot. And now we pass the ball above the head or like this for a shoot. Okay? Try to do it. I know it's hard, but try to do it. Alright. Go. Hop. Okay. Alright, pass.
Next one.
Bravo. Allez.
Laisse-lui faire sa fin d'abord. Laisse-lui faire sa fin. Et maintenant.
Ça goûte. Ando. Pivot. Protégé. Ok. Protégé. Opa. Catch. Bravo. Catch. Now. Opa. Hop. Comme ça. Protégé. Elbow. Elbow. Comme ça. Ok. Bravo. C'est good. C'est good. Bien. Allez, hop là. Allez. Oh, my God. So, okay. So we repeat this until they teach. And then we bring another defender. Defense here.
Donc on répète ça jusqu'à ce qu'ils aient compris et fait l'exercice correctement. Et maintenant on va juste passer devant.
So, as soon as you cross the hand or pass, sprint, sprint, sprint. Open. Now, in the moment I pass, you go and play 1-on-1 and we play 2-on-2. First, we give them 1-on-1, for example, 1-on-1, and then we go 2 against 2.
You understand? I have.
Two play 1-on-1. When you catch the ball, play 1-on-1.
Okay? Moment you score the pass, you 1-on-1.
So, it's not only the guards who has to be able to pass the ball well, it's also a big guy. So, whatever offense you play, Dynamo, flex, pick and roll, pick and pop offense. But big guys has to be able to pass the ball.
Ah, c'est pas seulement les ailiers ou les arrières qui doivent savoir passer la balle. Peu importe le système que vous allez faire, les grands vont devoir être capables de faire de bonnes passes aussi.
But you have to teach the kid how to pivot.
Mais vous devez automatiquement aussi apprendre à vos joueurs à pivoter correctement si on ne va pas derrière.
Alex, let's go. Pass. Hand up. Pivot. Hop, fast, 1-1. Bravo. 1-1, 2-2. Super. Allez. Très fast, chance, très fast. Allez. Hop, pass, hop. Protégé, pivot, pass. Allez, jouez. Hop. 2-2. Hop. Pass. Allez. Défense, ici. Hop. Pivot, pivot, pass. Play. Bravo, aïe. Hop là. Chance, hop là. Let's go, allez.
Pass.
crois pas.
So we are not going to talk a lot about handle, because I just wanted to show you how we teach them to handle the ball. Because most of the time, the biggest mistake in handle is to handle the ball like this.
Il dit on va pas trop parler du handoff, c'est pas le sujet aujourd'hui, mais c'est juste important de montrer la vraie technique du handoff parce que la plupart du temps on le fait avec les mains dans cette position et du coup c'est difficile de prendre la balle.
So defense you can do this if you have the ball like this.
So protège.
Comme on screen. Okay? That's the first thing. Second thing, selection of pass after handoff. Selection of pass. Above the head, yeah. Or from the hip. But if we didn't teach him that he has to do this, it's going to be very hard for him to pass.
Le choix de la passe après le handoff, ça va être soit au-dessus de la tête, soit depuis la hanche. Mais si on ne lui a pas expliqué dès le début comment faire, ça va être très compliqué pour lui de faire l'exercice.
Hey, it's good. No. Second situation, body guard. No good. Shooter.
Deuxième situation.
Défense. Offense, defense. Screen, defense. This is handicap drill because it's 3-2. Screen for shooter, Mike. Screen for shooter of the ball. Hey, sure. Okay. One more time. Curl now. So, selection of the pass. So, who is he looking? What are you looking? What's your target? He is looking at defender of his shooter. So he has to make a decision regarding the defender of the shooter.
Lui doit regarder le défenseur du shooter et prendre sa décision
par
rapport à ce que le défenseur sera.
If he screen cheats, what he do? He bumps off. And if this player is not ready,
l'exemple c'est si le défenseur triche. Lui va sortir à l'extérieur.
To make a selection of pass like this of the dribble or change and penetrate the pass or punish the pass, we're gonna have problems. So we have to teach him to read and make a good selection regarding this. So there are two ways to pass this ball. After dribble, every time he has to make a dribble. But we have to teach him to make a good dribble as a good preparation for the pass.
Pour ce genre de situation, il y aura automatiquement un dribble pour pouvoir faire une passe de qualité. Mais encore une fois, s'il n'a pas appris à pouvoir faire une bonne passe sur le dribble, l'exercice va être compliqué.
Allez, ready? Alors, let's go. It's too far. Too late. Ah, one more time.
Il est trop loin.
Now we tell this guy. Do whatever you want. Follow screen.
Screen, bravo.
Follow, curl. Whatever you want. You curl. Or cone 45 or pop on the ball. You whatever you want. So we practice his imagination, what to do, how to read the defense. So basically, we are entering 3-2 because this is handicapped because he doesn't have a defense. If we give him defense, maybe problems. So let's give them slowly first. 3-2, sans défense.
On commence avec un autre
dribble. Active dribble. Let's go, allez. Allez, one more time. Change of his defense. Hoppa. Active dribble. Okay, one more time. Pass. So selection of the pass in collaboration. This player. Let's go. Okay, So also collaboration between two shooters, selection of the pass of this player. If he curls, what he has to do? Curl.
Si par exemple l'attaquant curl, qu'est-ce que lui doit faire?
He cannot go to the ball. So if he sees that he is going to curl, he has to make one dribble back, to make a better angle of the screen.
Donc s'il voit que son attaquant coupe curl, il ne peut pas aller vers lui, il est obligé de s'écarter pour pouvoir un bon angle de passe.
And if he sees that he's going over,
he wants to go over the screen, so par-dessus,
he has to be ready to react with one or two dribbles to the ball to help the teammate to get better player, make a better pass.
Et si en revanche le défenseur passe au-dessus du bloc, il va devoir dribbler, se rapprocher de lui pour de nouveau trouver un bon angle de passe. Okay.
So now let's make a simple drill. String here, comes here, easy. Middle, okay. Try to receive the ball. Tell to try to receive the ball.
C'est de recevoir la balle.
And then try to put the ball inside.
Ensuite, essaye d'adonner dedans.
So, after the string, this player is fighting for inside position.
I'm on defense, wherever.
Defense with being low and showing where he wants the ball. I tell my players that we never pass unless he shows.
Ah, donc ensuite, le joueur intérieur va devoir lutter pour prendre la position.
No. When you see the target, then you pass.
Être bas sur ses jambes et surtout montrer où il veut recevoir la balle.
So, he is responsible to receive the ball.
How? Player, rest, whatever you want.
His hand is here. So, my job is to hand.
Défend.
To make myself free like this. Or, if he has advantage,
turn around,
swimming technique to attack his hand and gives him. So, technique of swimming. Or,
be aggressive.
Attacking the space first with the legs, and then when I'm ready, I'm going to show where I want to go. So, if I'm a short player and he's a big player, where do you want to pass?
Bravo, pass on the floor.
Bravo. If I'm a big player and he's a shorter player, where do you want to go? Bravo. Okay, so let's do it. Play two against two. After you receive the ball, ball goes in. Play two contra two. Two contra two. Okay,
bravo.
Good. And now we give this player defense.
No. Defense.
Be extra aggressive. Drill starts, 3-on-3.
You got the ball.
Hand off, and start. Defense, high. Hoppa. Now he has to make the pass. Hoppa. Hoppa. Bravo, bravo. Play. Bravo. Good. Jouer. Bravo. Change. Okay. Change off, is it? Now defense is going over the screen.
So the screen.
Tell him.
He goes over this.
Drop up on this field, right? Pass par dessus.
Corner. Selection of the pass. Let's see if he can make this pass. Alright, let's go.
Commence à jouer.
Commence ici.
Quand tu passes.
Allez. Ready? Let's go. So we see that he's not ready to pass this ball.
Donc on voit qu'Alan dans ce talent.
Just not ready. So let's not put him in this situation before we teach him.
Donc essayons par la suite de ne pas le mettre dans ce genre de situation tant qu'il ne l'a pas appris.
So you always have to fake. In basketball, unfortunately, you always have to fake when you do something. So if you going to pass there, fake that you're going to pass there.
On est obligé toujours de feinter. S'il veut passer à droite, il sera obligé de feinter.
So when he's getting ready, go. But it takes time to develop this type of imagination, but we have to develop his dribble and develop his passes to make it successful. Okay?
I do Put
the ball inside. Now, change off his defense. Defense. Now. Stop. So we give them these drills to develop the feeling for the game, but also we start, if we are going to have this on the practice, I will start the practice with isolating the elements first. So you isolate an element.
Donc là, on prend typiquement l'exercice final pour développer leur vision du jeu. Mais par contre, pour que l'exercice soit le mieux intégré possible, on va d'abord isoler certains éléments comme la passe en haut ou la passe en bas.
So you isolate the element in the beginning of the practice and you just give them collaboration of two players, two guards.
So, par exemple, commencer le début d'entraînement avec une relation simplement à deux et puis progressivement amener d'autres difficultés.
Okay, another thing, very good. What we do a lot, one inside player, one shooter, collaboration, inside out.
Offense.
So we give this player problem, we give him defense. This player is free, go to corner, do one defense. So we play. So position. So we got three against two. Pass the ball inside, the best way you can. Now, as soon as you catch the ball, you have to make a pivot, or back, or front pivot to stay in balance, open, after pass, you play, close out, you play three against two. And we develop a feeling, how to punish him. So after pass, what do you do? Après le pass, you have to come with. And we play three against two, okay? You understand?
No.
Let's go. Press the ball. Play. Bravo, play.
Bravo.
Play. One more time. One is right here. Good luck. Bravo. Now, we just give them change positions. After every set, you are here, you are there, you are there, you are on the ball and you're here. Let's go. Everybody is everywhere. Opa! Here's the ball. So make his life. Attack the ball. Bravo. So he has to work. So he has to create imagination. Bravo. Let's go. Press the ball. Hands.
Bravo.
Close out. Bravo! Excellent! Good, super! Change positions! You see that he decides subconsciously to pass with the right hand.
Because he has chosen to pass inconsciously with the right hand.
Because his left side is just subconsciously does not exist.
Parce que inconsciemment son côté gauche n'existe pas, car il n'est pas intégré.
I have to be ready to pivot all day without the ball.
Donc, il doit être capable de pouvoir pivoter sans arrêt avec le ballon en le protégeant.
So, whenever you're ready to pass, you must be ready to pass. Okay. Good job. Let's go. Excellent defense. Bravo. Good job. Bravo. Opa. Allez. Bravo. Bravo. So, we tell this guy, super, penetration, super, but he's free, passing the ball. We have to tell, he's free, pass the ball to free player. Opa. Alex, same thing.
Bravo.
And on the end, 3-on-3.
Et enfin, la dernière possibilité, 3-on-3, au bout de la chaîne.
Et I think 3-on-3, right? defense on the post, defense.
Defense.
So position, ball goes in, pass, Joey fighting, here, pass, try to pass under pressure, bravo, defense, real. So this is handicapped, because we give advantage to offense because we say this player come here and then we attack after diagonal pass.
Là par exemple, je joue 3 contre 3 avec un handicap, je demande au défenseur à l'opposé d'être complètement en aide défensive et donc d'aller en un contre 1 que lorsque son attaquant reçoit la balle.
For example, we have a system in senior team. Stay in the corner. Here, please. Here, see. Offense, defense. Offense, defense. Coach in the corner. Coach. Pass. So we have a system with this element. It's called motion. We have to pass the ball. Pass the ball. Back pick. Back
screen. System back screen. For example,
back screen. Cut. 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 Offense, defense. Come on. Offense, defense, Alec. Pass. Bravo. Cut. Bravo. Now, stop, stop. Now, dribble. You have to hit this shooter. This shooter. Screen, screen for Alec. Bravo. Try to do it. Try to do it. Try to do it. Come against it. Complete. Pass. Pass. Go. 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 Pass. Cut.
One
more time, one more. Okay. And make a turnover, right? Do. And when they make a turnover, I will stop. Right. Pass, cut. Okay, so for no advantage, that means offense is not good. So now, why? Now, if they make turnover, I have to ask myself why.
Donc là, typiquement, il n'y a eu aucun avantage, donc du coup, il y a des balles perdues.
And this is the main thing in our job, that we locate the problem.
Et notre principal rôle, c'est de savoir d'où vient l'erreur. Pourquoi est-ce qu'il n'y a pas eu d'avantage?
Beginning of the offense. Most of the time, I locate that the problem is problem of technical element.
Et la plupart du temps, localiser le problème, c'est bien souvent de la technique individuelle.
Pass. Bravo. First of all, we are not talking about screen again, but make a good screen. Good screen.
Bravo.
Go. Side. Bravo. Stop. Pass. See the basket. See the basket. You're shooting. See the basket. Cut. Stop. First of all, this player is not ready to catch the ball because he's not changing the rhythm. So two people are responsible for the pass. The passer and the catcher.
D'abord, ce joueur n'est pas prêt à recevoir la balle parce qu'il n'y a pas de changement de rythme. Il y a toujours deux personnes responsables pour la passe, celui qui passe et celui qui reçoit.
So you have to see the ball and see the player who pass the ball.
Tu dois regarder la balle et celui qui va faire la passe.
And you have to help him make a good screen in order to win. He has to open the passing lane.
Opa.
And now you have to be free. So now, if he didn't receive the ball here, I have a problem. All the problem is here. Because he's not able to pass from the dribble. Or the problem is not good screen making. I must locate the problem, isolate him, and work on the problem.
Par exemple, donc si Alain n'arrive pas à avoir un avantage à la fin de ce système, ça veut dire qu'il y a un problème. Soit il peut venir du passeur qui n'arrive pas à ouvrir l'angle de passe, ou alors ça vient du bloc qui n'arrive pas à être bien posé. Mais dans tous les cas, il va falloir isoler le problème et le retravailler individuellement, comme les exercices qu'on a fait auparavant.
So, usually when we talk about passing, problem is, or the catcher is didn't prepare himself to receive the ball, or the passer didn't do the right thing with dribbling or pivot.
Voilà, donc ça veut dire que les problèmes de la passe, c'est pas que le passeur, mais ça peut venir aussi du réceptionneur qui est peut-être pas prêt à recevoir la balle ou qui n'a pas réussi à soulever.
Three with the balls, three balls, one, two, three, ballon, souffle.
Yeah.
How we start the practice when we talk about pick and roll offense? This is how we start the practice.
Comment on peut commencer un entraînement parlant pick and roll?
Corner, one coach makes the screen, Mike. Will you come make the screens, please? Screen. So what do you have to do to make this pass good? So attack the pick, this pick, pick, pick. So what do you have to do to make this pass in the corner? Let's see. Try to make the best possible pass in the corner. Like you're attacking the pick.
Very good.
Bravo.
shoot. Change.
Let's go. Okay. And we play against the team. Come back. We play against the team that is hedging, and we know that they are hedging.
Et on joue par exemple contre une équipe qui va.
Hedge. They're hedging. So his decision making has to be done in less than a second. What is this pass? What we do? Is it this? Is it this? If you come, but whatever you want. It's your decision, but you have to be ready for everything. Okay? Opa. Be ready to punish shot. Now let's go. Ale. Hedge. Bravo. Ale. Hedge. Too late. Opa. Let's go. Now you come when you place pick the camera. Okay?
Let's go. Same thing. Start there. Stop by with your motor, Momo is pick it
up. Alright, Ale. Now, Ale. Defense is hedging. Decision of this player. Offense. Defense in the middle. Defense. This is your player. You're in the middle. This is your player.
C'est ton joueur qui est au milieu en net.
En fait, la hedge. Ready. Upside. So, if we want the player to do this,
si on veut que les joueurs soient capables de faire ça,
we have to teach this player to dribble, to stop, and to pass correctly.
Donc on doit apprendre à son joueur à savoir dribbler, à savoir s'arrêter, et enfin à savoir passer.
Allez, let's go. Hop, good. It's okay. Good, hey. It's good, hey. Who? Or? Or? Treasury, we go, and we pass. But he has to pass to stop. He cannot pass like this.
So this is offensive foul. Il doit absolument s'arrêter pour pouvoir faire la passe.
So, when he do it, hop, get that, go. He has to make a decision to stop like this.
Il doit prendre la décision de pouvoir s'arrêter pour pouvoir faire une bonne passe.
We go on, come on. Where is the best? You're the best. No.
Best dribbler.
Defense. And we play 3 against 1. 3 contra 1. Handicap drill. Just to begin.
Alright, strike handicap.
He's your player. C'est ton jeu. Okay? Après le pass, when you pass, you close up. Pass, pass. Close up. Penetrate. Pass. Boom. Bravo. Take a shot. Okay? So let's do it. Let's go. So selection of pass. Head. Bravo. Penetrate. Help. Close up. Play. Opa. Bravo. Shoot.
Bravo.
Good. Change. Now you go there. You go there. You take the ball over there. One example. Alea. Opa. Decision. Bravo. Pass. Play. Bravo. Bravo. Super. Okay. 3 against 1. 3 contra 1.
Defense.
3 contra 2. But we start 3 on 0. I'm pitch.
3 contra 2. Nous on commence à 3 contre 0.
Ouais. Help. Ouais.
Stop.
Ball. You pass the ball. He passed the ball. Move. Okay. He catch. Now he pray. We also practice his instincts. He close up. Penetrate. Attack. Boy. Maybe he can pass this. Or he's very good. Vas, Vas here. So we practice his imagination.
Ah, I want to go.
He is yours. He is yours. I want to go. Play. Okay. I mean, this is just an example that I want to talk to you about under 14, under 12. This is a sensitive age to teach the players basics, really. The passing, how to hold the ball, how to use the footwork. And believe me, if you teach them this, only this, they don't have to know nothing about zone, about pressing, about pick and roll. If they are under 10, under 12, if you teach them how to hold the ball, how to pivot, how to protect the ball, you gave those players incredibly much.
La conclusion, c'est vraiment ça, c'est que sur les catégories U10, U12 et même U14, sans vous compliquer la tâche, simplement en leur apprenant les bases, comme vous l'avez vu aujourd'hui, savoir passer, pivoter, protéger sa balle, etc. Construisez une base très solide avec vos joueurs, sans anticiper sur des systèmes, zones, etc.
You will give them everything. You will give them basketball life.
Vous leur donnerez vraiment tout du basket.
I was really proud to be with you tonight, and I've been on many clinics, and sometimes I pick up one detail, sometimes I pick up two or three details. I hope that everybody here picked up something that can use in his training process or in his year selection of drills. If you have any questions, I'm here to answer, really, regarding everything. You can ask. And of course, you must know that we are here always for you in any day of the week. If you need consulting, if you need help, if you need practice, if you need to watch my practice in the morning or in the evening, we are always open for you. And our doors are always open.
Il est très fier d'avoir pu être ici et vous offrir ce clinique-là. Il a lui-même participé à beaucoup de cliniques en Europe. Et puis à chaque fois, bah, on va retenir un ou deux éléments. Mais ces éléments sont toujours importants à voir. Maintenant, ce qu'il aimerait, c'est que vous sachiez que la porte est toujours ouverte pour ceux qui sont intéressés à téléphoner, à avoir des conseils, à venir voir même un entraînement le matin ou le soir, si vraiment c'est quelque chose qui vous intéresse. Il n'y a absolument aucun souci pour nous contacter là-dessus.
There are many things that I didn't show you because we had to stop a lot because of some details, but there is also decision making in pick and pop, etc., etc. But I'm really happy that I was with you here tonight. And please, one more applause for our guys. Good job. Good job.
One team!
Thank you. Regarding pass or dribble or shot, I'm here. If not, I wish you all the best on your work. See you next time.
Okay, thank you.